Hello students, welcome to DAV Moyle Public School E class of standard 7, subject science, and today we are going to learn the topic nutrition in living organisms, plant. Nutrition. What do we mean by nutrition? Every living organism needs food. Because food provides us energy. Food stores the energy in the form of chemical energy. So, it is necessary to unlock this energy or to release this energy. This energy is being released by converting the food into small and small soluble molecules. Different organisms get and utilize their food in different ways. So, the process of making, the process of obtaining and utilizing food is known as nutrition. So, what is nutrition? Nutrition is the process of obtaining and utilizing the food is known as nutrition. There are two modes of nutrition, autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. My dear students, I will like to ask you one question. If you have a plant, tulsi plant, usually we used to keep the tulsi plant in a house and some pet also. Like cat or dog, we used to feed that cat, dog by milk, or you used to give some food. But my dear student, did you give food to your tulsi pot? No, isn't it? Why? Because plants prepare their own food. So, autotrophic nutrition, it is a mode of nutrition in which the organism can make their own food by the simple raw materials are called as autotrophic nutrition. Heterotrophic nutrition, it is the mode of nutrition in which the organism cannot prepare their own food. Like you can see in your picture, deer. Deer used to feed on the other plants, small plants. Next mode of nutrition in plants. It is clear that plant prepared their own food. So, what is the process? What is the name of that process in which the plant prepare their own food? Plant prepare their own food by the process photosynthesis. Photo means light and synthesis means to prepare. It means plants are able to prepare their food in the presence of sunlight, as you can see in your picture. So, photosynthesis is the process by which the plant prepare their own food. So, plant is preparing their food. Isn't it? So, plant needs some raw material also, because without the raw material we cannot prepare a food. So, in the same way, plant also needs some raw material. First is water and mineral. Plant take this raw material like water and mineral from the soil. And who takes this raw material from the soil? They are the roots. They are roots. From roots, plant absorb water and minerals from the soil. There are certain tissues. You will learn in your higher classes which tissues are responsible for taking this food. There are tissues named as xylem and phloem. which are responsible for taking the water and mineral from the roots. The next component which is being required for the photosynthesis process is carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is available from the atmosphere. But from where does this carbon dioxide enters in the plant? This carbon dioxide is entered in the plant through the leaves. Leaves have small tiny pores called as stomata. As you can see in the picture, tiny pores, the enlarged picture of the stomata. Through this stomata, carbon dioxide enters in the leaves, and leaves is called as the kitchen of the plant because all these photosynthesis process occurs in the leaf itself. Another raw material required for the photosynthesis process is sunlight, and this sunlight we used to get from the sun. So now it is clear that the photosynthesis process occurs only in the daytime in the presence of sun. Next component which is being used for the photosynthesis process is chlorophyll, and chlorophyll is present in the leaf itself. The green colored pigment present in the leaf is called as chlorophyll, and because of this chlorophyll only, the color of the leaves are green. Now, photosynthesis process means preparation of food. So, what is the product? What is being prepared by the plant? They prepare carbohydrate. So, the photosynthesis process, in photosynthesis process, carbohydrate is being formed. Carbohydrate contains carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. This carbohydrate is again converted into starch. Some carbohydrate is also converted to proteins and fats. Another mode of nutrition is saprotrophic nutrition. Saprotrophic nutrition is the process in which the organism feeds on dead and decaying matter. For example, mushroom, bread mold. It is the extracellular digestion. It means the organism which is feeding on the dead and decaying organism releases their digestive juice on that dead organism. With the help of that digestive juice, that food is being converted into the simpler form. It means it is digested outside the body only, and then it is being consumed by that organism. Another mode of nutrition is symbiotic relationship. Symbiotic relationship means, I will like to give one example. If two friends having two chocolates, one having Cadbury and another one having the Perk, but both of them wants to eat the other's chocolate. So the first one ready to give his chocolate, but he is demanding that you will also have to give your chocolates. This type of relationship, like give and take, is called as symbiotic relationship. In the living organism, there is also symbiotic relationship. The organism living in association and developing a relationship that is beneficial to both is called as symbiotic relationship. Examples are algae and fungi lives in the roots of the tree. They are living in the roots of the tree. But in return, tree provides shelter and nutrition to the plant. But in return, they helps the tree to absorb the water and minerals more efficiently. Second example is Rhizobium bacteria. This type of bacteria is living in the roots of the leguminous plants. This leguminous bacteria helps the plant to convert the nitrogen from the atmosphere, into the soluble form and provide it to the plant. And in return, the plant provides food and shelter to the bacterium. My dear students, now there is a worksheet for you. I know you don't have the textbook of the 7th standard, but listen to the video clip twice and thrice. You will able to get the answer of each and every question which is given in this worksheet, and you have to solve these questions in your notebook. First question is, what is autotrophic nutrition? Second, what do you mean by heterotrophic nutrition? Next, what are the raw material used for photosynthesis process? What is the function of stomata? What are the products of photosynthesis process? What do you mean by symbiotic relationship? Thank you. Stay safe at home.